Hello everyone. Today in this lecture, I am going to talk about the system that gives us energy. Yes, I am talking about the digestive system. As you can see on the board, I have drawn a very important organs associated with this system. So this organ plays a very important role in our body, because whatever we eat, that mechanically or chemically digested, it breaks down and it goes into our blood, lymph, and finally it reaches in our cell. So thereby we are getting energy, as well as we have nutrients for our growth, as well as these all nutrients help in wound healing as well. So this system plays a very important role, and here in this lecture I am briefing about its important organ, which all are present in this digestive system, as well as what all function it plays. Okay, so let's talk about its component, that is what all organs are there. So basically it is divided into two parts, that is one is GI tract, or the gastrointestinal tract, or you can say alimentary canal. So this is a tubular structure. This GI tract is a tubular structure that starts from mouth, it ends in anal region, anus. Okay, so this is whole tube like structure from where food is passing, and finally in form of waste it is excreting out from our body. So this is the basic thing. So the organ which all are present in GI tract is the mouth, then the food goes into the pharynx, then to the esophagus, that is food pipe, and from here it enters into the stomach, where it stays for about few hours for proper mixing with various enzymes and the secretions, and thereby the food passes in the small intestine and lastly in the large intestine. So this whole tubular tract is called as GI tract or the alimentary canal. And the other division in digestive system is the accessory organ. Accessory organ because these all are supported the tract for further digestion. Okay, like the accessory organs include teeth, because once we eat food it lies in our mouth, so teeth help in chewing. Okay, it mechanically breaks food in smaller substance. Yes, as the food particles became small in size, what happened, it mixes with various juices. Yes, so once it mixes with all the juices, the tongue help in mixing all food with the secretion and propulsive this food material back of our mouth, that is toward the pharynx. So the accessory organs are teeth, tongue. Okay, but some accessory organs never come in contact with the food directly, but they releases some secretion via the ducts, and then the secretion mixes with these food particles. Okay, so the accessory organs which are not coming in contact with the food are the salivary glands, liver, gall bladder, and pancreas. So these all are called accessory organs. So altogether, this whole digestive system is divided into two. One is the whole tubular tract, that is GI tract, and the other, that is accessory organ, that support this GI tract for further digestion. Okay, so these are the organs which are associated with the digestive system. Now the length of this GI tract in cadaver is about 30 feet, because at the time of death what happened, the smooth muscles become relaxes, thereby the length of GI tract remain longer in comparison to the living person. Because in living person what happened, the smooth muscle tonicity remains suspended, and that causes less length in comparison to the cadaver persons. Okay, now let's talk about what all processes took place in this digestive system. It means what all function the system plays. So firstly, the basic thing is we are eating food. So the food which we eat goes in our mouth. So whatever the solid, whatever the liquid we are taking, that is the first step is ingestion of food. Okay, so first is ingestion of food, and once it enters in our mouth, then what happened, It comes in contact with the various secretion of GI tract. Okay, so the second step, or you can say the second function, is the secretion of acid, secretion of buffers, secretion of enzymes. Okay, so GI tract releases various secretion via the glands, via the cells. Okay, so once we eat food, it ingested in a mouth and then it mixes with various secretion. Then what happened? It mixes with secretion. So third function is mixing and propulsion, because once it mixes with the secretion, is it remain in mouth only? No, it is continuously mixing with all secretion and go along with whole tract. Yes, so mixing and propulsion, moving forward continuously all along the tract, is the third function. Then once it mixes and propulses toward the various organ, what happened? There are various organs that help in digestion of food particle. It can be mechanically or it can be chemically. So like in mouth, once we are taking food, the larger bite we are taking, it is not going in as it is manner, because the tongue help in mechanically digesting the food particle in a smaller substance, isn't so? So chewing of food is the mechanical digestion that took place in our mouth. Yes, and then it goes all along the tract, where it mixes with various muscular contraction. That is the mechanically, these all substances are breaking down, but not even mechanically digested, whereas in various enzymes and various secretions, these all we'll discuss later. So various secretions and enzymes are also releasing by the glands and the cells of all the GI tract that further digest this food particle chemically. It means the larger substances break down in a simple substances. If we are taking an example of starch, then this starch chemically breaks down and forms glucose. Yes, so starch is not absorbing as it is. It is absorbing in form of glucose. Yes, so the next function is the digestion, that is the digestion of food particle mechanically or chemically. Yes, now after digestion, what happened? Once the food is chemically also break down, it enters into small intestine, the structure which is mainly responsible for absorption of all the nutrients. So here what happened? All the essential nutrient, the simpler components of all the nutrients are usually absorbed. This all enters into the blood or lymph, and these all transported across our body cells. Okay, so absorption is the another process or the function of this system. Then after absorption, what happened? Whatever the waste is remaining here, like the indigested food, the bacteria, the sludge of cells of all long GI tract, or the waste, that is after absorption, whatever is remaining, this all mixes together and forms a waste product that is eliminated via this anal part. Okay, so the excretion which is coming out through this anal part is called fecal material or the stool. Okay, and this process is called defecation. So the processes which took place in digestive system is the ingestion of food, then it mixes with the various secretions of all along the GI tract, then the secretions mixes all the food particle together, then propulses all along the tract. Finally, the digestion took place, where it breaks down mechanically and chemically, then absorbs the important nutrient in our blood, and finally remove all the waste which is left. Okay, so this is the process or the function that is took place in this digestive system. So here in this lecture, I have given you a brief description about the system, the organs, and the function. Later on in upcoming videos, I will discuss each organ in detail. Thank you.